We are back in Fairstead, and as you can see, I have unlocked 25 tiles so that we can complete Fairstead before we get to City Skylines 2. I want to put in an official downtown. We're going to put in the airport at some point, and I want to get rid of a lot of the harsh lines that we can see on the map from where we were confined to our 9 tiles. But today I want to start on the road layout for the downtown. And yes, we are going to start the downtown by using this lovely pre-built interchange from the amazing Yumble, just to help make our lives a bit easier so we can get started right away on the road layout for the downtown. Okay, we are not going to mess with the terrain much for this downtown area. I am going to let our downtown develop around the terrain that is here for the most part. And I think that's going to make for a really unique downtown area. I'm very excited about that. I want to make sure we leave this, and we'll incorporate that into the build as well. Now, before we get started, I want to make sure we think about bringing some connectivity besides the highway, because we do want some local roads connecting over into our downtown area. So I'm going to grab this little 4-lane road. I'm going to upgrade this and pull this through. And let's get a second road connection here as well. Let's see, can we sneak through here? Perfect. We may want to rework that area and get something that goes to the university. And for sure, we want to get a road through here underneath as well. This is just going to set us up in the future for making sure that we are having as many connections as possible to ease the traffic going into the downtown. I'm actually going to lean into the height of the terrain that's here and just make this a bigger area for us to build our downtown on top of. So I'm just going to move this out a little bit just to give us a little bit more room on the top of this hill. Okay, next thing I'm doing is bringing our main arterial that's coming off of the highway, and we are going to have this main road that goes actually underneath our downtown area but then comes up in the middle. I'm very excited for this idea. I'm going to actually grab dirt roads and let's work on our road layout for this whole downtown area. I really love doing road layouts. You guys let me know in the comments if that's something you enjoy doing as well. Even if they change as you have to make room for different buildings or decide that you want things to flow a little different way, I really like getting a base road layout structure done before I dive in to any sort of building or transportation placement, which we will be doing today as well. We're going to be bringing trams, metro, and the train into the downtown from the rest of our city, which I'm very excited about. All right, let me get this road layout put in. Hopefully this will be a very satisfying watch. We'll be right back. One of the things I'm going to try to do with this town to the best of my ability is to implement the meow method of detailing from none other than the famous Jukuboa. I have his most recent video that he did for the Skyline 6 summer vacation linked below. So if you haven't yet, go check it out. It's fantastic. Now back to our road layout. Oh, I am so happy with how this came together. I love the mix of the curvy roads and the grids, and I'm so excited to fill this area out. But I think we need to think about connecting straight from our university. So I think we do need to make some pretty significant changes. Okay, now we are fully connected. We've got our entire road layout kind of mapped out, which I'm so happy about. We've got a direct connection right into the university, which I feel like is going to be really important. So the other thing as I'm looking at this is I really think that I want to bring the tram road to the water side of the downtown and connect up to the university to be near the train station. That's going to take a little bit of work and will kind of change my original idea, but I think it's really going to be worth it. And we have the space, so why not do that? And that means we get to use one of my new favorite assets, which is the combination metro and tram stop, because then we could also bring the metro right to here, which would be excellent. So let's get this all set up. Okay, we're gonna grab our 4-lane tram road and we're gonna bring this right down the center of this area and right down to our tram. Clean this up a little bit. Perfect. And then we'll bring this right underneath. So we're going to turn this into a tram road. We'll go with the 4-lane tram road and we'll just come underneath. I think that's gonna be perfect. I'm excited to have the connectivity of the trams all the way into the downtown. I think that's gonna be really great right from the train station and now the metro and the university. Although we definitely will bring a new train station that I'm excited to use and a new metro station that I'm excited to use that we just got from the Railroads of Japan. You'll have to excuse my voice today. I am getting over being sick, so if I sound a little froggy today, that's why. All right, so let's go ahead and move in to getting the rest of our transportation set up. I am so excited about this. So let's go into our metro here, and we're gonna grab this and bring this all the way around. This was a short metro line that was coming from our intercity bus station over to the sports fields. So it's perfect that we get to extend this line now, which I'm very excited about. And then let's make sure we get a line on either side here. It's always a little tricky to do. There we go. Perfect. Okay, this is exciting. I'm really happy about this. Let's go ahead and fix this path up here. I'm actually kind of glad that we had this park space open in the university because it did make it pretty easy to redevelop it and bring this road connection through. So I'm very excited about that. Okay, let's bring a little detail to this area before we move on and just get this looking snazzy. Okay, I think that's good enough for now. We can do some more detailing and bring it to the university to this area later. So now I want to bring in this metro station. I've been eyeing this one. I think it's so perfect for downtown. I'm so excited about this one. The building is beautiful. This one right here. It's like we'll need to make a little bit of room for it in our grid, but I am obsessed. I think this is so perfect for a downtown area. The building is so beautiful. Look at this. Look at this. All sides. The detail. Oh, I just love this. And it's like the perfect large metro station for a downtown. I am surprised for the size of the building that there's only one metro running through it. I would think a building like that would have one each way and then we could connect up through that way, but we'll figure that out. Okay, let's get this line connected. This is the train station from one of the train stations from the Railroads of Japan. Also, I love this building as well. It's very simple, very basic, but lots of great detail. Okay, and I think what we'll do for to solve the metro issues, we'll just put a metro facing this direction. And then that'll be nice too, because then we'll have a metro and a train line that are angled to go over the highway and out to this other peninsula, which is where I want to put our cruise ship terminal and have like an actual port build too, which will be really fun to do over there. I think I'm just gonna connect this way. Yeah, I think that's gonna work just fine. We'll make sure to do a lot of detailing around here. We'll probably use Move It. I think this will work out. Okay, now I do want to think about how we're gonna connect this up. So I think we can do some sort of nice sweeping motion across the highway and hook up into our market station. So give me a moment and let me see how this is best going to work over the freeway. Okay, I think that's gonna work. It's a bit of a tight curve. You guys have to let me know in the comments if it's just too tight of a curve for that drain line. We can always work on that a little bit. Okay, so we're gonna put down this little compact bus station here. And then I also wanna have another bus station up here. I do like that one. Is there something larger that maybe we should use? Actually, I think we'll just go. We already have our inner city bus station right down by the market station down the hill. So I think we'll just go with this compact one here as well. I think that'll work really nice. So we've got our train connected. We've got our metro connected. We've got a tram line. We still need to put in the tram depot, which we will do next time. We still got to figure out where our bike network is going to go through the downtown. We'll figure that out next time as well. But I am so happy that we are set up to dive in next episode and start building out our downtown. I could not be more excited for this project. I hope you have enjoyed coming back to Fairstead with me. I'm excited to finish these projects before we get into City Skylines 2, which I know I am so excited about. And just as a reminder, come and join the City of Friends Discord. There are a lot of really great creators hanging out there and just community members. It's a really fun place to be. Remember, every Sunday this summer, there'll be a new Skyline 6 episode from the Skyline 6 Summer Vacation, our multiplayer series, our last collaboration in City Skylines 1. Also, I have channel memberships. I put a new video every Friday, so there are 11 videos for you to enjoy now, and of course, there'll be a new one every single week. I hope you all have a joyful day, and I'll catch you next time.